Okay, thank you very much. It's a great pleasure to be here today, even if not face to face, and great to have so many connected. So I'm Timo Jämsä. I'm from University of Oulu, Finland, and past president of EAMPES. And I will have a quite short presentation on EAMPES. We are a community representing biomedical engineering in Europe. And non-profit organization with representing most of the scientific societies in the domain and also several institutions and quite a nice number of more than 100 distinguished fellows representing the key experts in the field. We are not alone as EAMPES, but we are a part of the European, beyond Europe, the global biomedical engineering community. EAMPES is a member of IFMB, that is the International Federation of Medical and Biological Engineering. That is jointly with the medical physicists represented in the International Science Council. And via IFMB, we have also an official relation with WHO that has been very valuable, for instance, in these times with COVID-19. And we have some priorities that we would like to collaborate with the EU Parliament. We have done that, and we will want to do that also in future, related to patient safety, sustainability of healthcare, support manufacturing of medical devices, the creation of the European data space. And practically, we are willing to support when preparing new directives that are related to health technologies. And of course, in the current topic, AI and digital health are very, very up-to-date issues here, as already Leandro mentioned. And also to blueprint the future research initiatives. And EAMPES is also willing to support United Nations for the Sustainable Development Goals. And I would like to shortly give just few examples of, I would say, great examples on how we are working as biomedical engineers for the community. So Professor Maria Chiara Carocha, one of EAMPES fellows, she was recently appointed as president of the Italian National Research Council. He is one of the leading experts in biorobotics, biomechatronics, neuroengineering, rehabilitation, very important areas in biomedical engineering, and also former Italian Minister of Education, Universities and Research. Professor Magdalena Stoeva, she is editor-in-chief of the IUPESUM journal, Health and Technology, and she has been very strongly leading a topical collection of biomedical engineering contributions to the COVID-19 response. And there has been a special focus for low and middle income countries, where the support is really needed. And Dr. Kaliroi Stavrinou, technical manager of EAMPES, she has strongly supported the collaboration with WHO, especially organizing a great series of webinars, sharing knowledge, success stories among clinical engineers during this pandemic. And more than 20 webinars have been organized with more than 100 speakers from more than 50 countries, reaching more than 1,000 attendees worldwide. Great, great contribution. And many EAMPES community members have been working actively to strengthening the response to COVID-19 and beyond in very close collaboration with WHO. One special mentioning to highlight Professor Dan Clark, and who has been awarded recently with an Officer of the Order of the British Empire by Her Majesty of Queen on the services in clinical engineering, especially related COVID-19. Here we are now in European Parliament Interest Group on Biomedical Engineering that was established in 2016. The first meeting was held in Brussels in 2016 in collaboration with IFMB, with IUPSM, with World WHO and MedTech Europe. And the topics highlighted were recognition, regulation, representation, harmonization, and research related to biomedical engineering. The second meeting was held in 2018 in Brussels. And in the second meeting, we also included cooperation with Africa as a very important field to be responded now and in future. So, EAMPES is willing to continue supporting the European Parliament and Commission for the current and future health policies with some points for discussion. The regulations of medical devices, personal protective equipment, and artificial intelligence. To raise the attention on emerging challenges. To contribute to the focus on European research and innovation investments for acute and important needs like aging, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, and so on. And to foster the creation of the EU data space, enabling the growth of EU AI for health. Thank you.